Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. Mr. Deputy Chairman, sir, the bill before the House is for the abolition of two-member constituencies and for setting up single-member constituencies. In other words, the present double-member constituencies are proposed to be bifurcated as single-member constituencies with reservation of seats or constituencies for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. Now, sir, a very crucial moment in the history of our young democracy has come. Where from has this reservation arisen? Is not reservation repugnant to the very principle of democracy? Still, we have reconciled ourselves to this reservation. A reservation might be in any form. It might be in the form of constituencies. It might be for the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. It is a fact of history that in our society, there are people who are called weaker sections and they go by the name of scheduled castes and scheduled tribes. I do not know whose fault it is, but anyway, in our society, we find a section of people who are said to be weak. Certainly, they are weak. Their cases deserve to be considered and should be given topmost priority, but there is a lot of misapprehension when we talk of reservation of seats. Is a single number of the Harijan community or scheduled castes going to solve the problem of the entire Harijan population? Self-reliance, self-respect, and things like this are talked of. How do they come? Will they come only by making a single man a member of the assembly or parliament? Will that give self-respect to the entire community? On the other hand, I would believe that self-respect, self-reliance, or self-confidence, whatever you call it, can come more by education, more by economic upliftment, more by spread of culture, more by mingling with other classes of people, and these are the measures that are called for at present in order to uplift the weaker sections of the people. Anyway, they are there. Millions of rupees are spent on the uplift of these people, and I am sure never before in the history of this country such a lot of good to these people was done as is being done within these 20 or 30 years of our independence. I am sure all these differences would disappear and India will emerge as a cohesive nation, but in the meanwhile, something has to be done, full stop.